Hello and welcome to Controllers Tech. This is yet another video covering the inter-core communication between the STM32 CPUs, and today we will see how to use the FreeRT OS with the OpenAMP. This is the continuation from the previous video, so if you haven't watched it, please watch the previous video first. I will continue from where I left off in that video. We will basically do the same, where the M7 core, which is the master, will send the data to the M4 core, the slave. The data will be then sent to the UART by the M4 core. The explanation has been covered in the previous video, so I will just focus on the RTOS part. This is the previous project we covered. We need to enable the RTOS, so let's go to the CubeMX. Enable the FreeRTOS for Cortex M4. Go to the Tasks and Queues tab. Here the default task is already created, so we will just change its name to the RX task. The RX task will be used to receive the data from the master. Note that its priority is set to normal. Let's create one more task, the TX task. It will be used to send the data to the UART. We will keep its priority lower than the RX task, so I am setting it to below normal. Now add one binary semaphore, so that we can restrict TX task from sending data continuously. That's it for the Cortex M4, enable the RTOS for the Cortex M7. We will again create two tasks here, one for sending the data to the slave, and another one for receiving the data from the slave. Though we are not going to receive any data from the slave, we still need to check for the message to know if the service has been destroyed by the slave. We don't need any semaphore here, as we will send the data periodically. Since we are using RTOS, we need to use a timebase other than the SysTick. So I am enabling the timer 6 for the Cortex M7, and timer 7 for the Cortex M4. Now select the appropriate timebase source. That's it for the configuration, click Save to generate the project. There is a warning about the new library reentrant, but that's alright, go ahead and generate the code. Let's build both the files once. I will start with the Cortex M4 first. This part is used to initialize the OpenAMP and create the endpoint. We will put it inside the RX task, and it will only run once in the beginning. Since the RX task has higher priority, it will run first, and initialize the OpenAMP. After the initialization is over, it will acquire the semaphore, so the TX task does not run. The TX task is responsible for sending the data to the UART, so this part goes there. We will shield this with the semaphore, so to send the data, first it has to acquire the semaphore. Since we are using RTOS, we will use the malloc and free functions to create an array of characters. So the TX task needs to acquire the semaphore before sending the data. But the semaphore is already acquired by the RX task. Therefore, once the message is received, we will free the semaphore, so that the TX task can acquire it and send the data. Now inside the RX task, we will continuously check for the data sent by the master. Finally, the RX task is as follows. Once the control enters it, the OpenAMP will be initialized. Then the endpoint is created, and it will acquire the semaphore. Then it will continuously check for the data sent by the master, every 10 milliseconds. Once the data is received, the data will save in the variable, and the semaphore will be released. After that, the TX task will send the data to the UART, and again try to acquire the semaphore. Let's delete this. Also, the data is defined in the TX task itself. That's all for the slave, now we will write the code for the master. Here I am leaving the message as 1. We will again copy the initialization inside the RX task. After the initialization is over, the RX task will check for the message from the slave. And now the transmission of data will take place in the TX task. It will run every second. As I mentioned, the slave is not sending any data, so the check for message is only used to check if the service is destroyed by the slave. The master should only check for message if the service is created, and if it is destroyed, the OpenAMP will deinitialize. Alright, let's build and flash the code. I am using the same debug configuration from the previous project. Let's reset the board. Here you can see the message is being printed on the console every 1 second. So our project is working fine so far. Now let's say I want to deinitialize the OpenAMP after some time. If the message value is equal to 15, the slave will deinitialize the OpenAMP, and also terminate the TX and RX tasks. This will destroy the service, and the master should also do the same. When the tasks are terminated, an ideal task should run in both the cores, and we will see this while debugging the project. Terminating tasks is not the ideal solution. Rather, you can just suspend them, and write a separate task for initializing the OpenAMP again, and then resume the tasks to do their job. I am just terminating them so that the TX task does not try to send data while the OpenAMP is deinitialized. For debugging, we use the same configuration for M7 core, but make sure the M4 file here is on the top. Then go to the Cortex M4 main file, and create a new debug configuration. Select None under the Reset Behavior. Make sure the port number is at least 4 higher than the M7. Go to the Startup tab, double-click on the configuration, and uncheck the Download option. Now debug using the M7 configuration. When fully loaded, again load the M4 configuration. Alright, now select both the main files using the control button, and click Run. The message is being printed. And it stopped at 14, because as soon as it reached 15, the OpenAMP was deinitialized, and the tasks were terminated. Hence the TX task could not send the message to the console. If you pause the debugger now, You can see the ideal tasks are running in both the cores. So we saw how to deinitialize the OpenAMP after a certain condition was met. Now let's quickly see how to transfer a string, or some character data. Here I am creating another variable in the M4 core. This is a character pointer. Inside the receive callback function, we will simply typecast the data into the character pointer. Since we are receiving the data in the character form, we will use the S format rather than U. The rest of the code remains unchanged. For the master, I am first defining the string I am going to send. And while sending the data, I am using the string length function to calculate the length here. Make sure to add a 1 to the length. It should be an array. Alright, let's run the code again. You can see the string is being displayed on the console. So I hope you understood how to use the OpenAMP with FreeRTOS, and how to send the string or characters between the cores. I will make more videos covering more methods to do the same. I will also make a video covering a practical application of inter-core communication. That's it for this video. The link to download the code is in the description below. Leave comments in case of any doubt. Keep watching, and have a nice day ahead.